Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas Room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Hi guys, it looks like Nikon did a firmware update for the D600, the D610, and the D750. So I remember reading that and I was thinking, well, the 850 is supposed to be coming out because they announced that for their birthday. And I saw a couple of leaked images and I figured, what would I like to see in the new Nikon D850? And I guess you guys have a wish list in your mind too. Even if you're not a Nikon user, you're a Canon user, you use the GH5, you use one of the Sony cameras, whether you're a stills photographer, you do weddings, events, sports photography, pictures of the stars. what else is there that, you know, you could be doing out there? There's baby photographers, which is a great business, by the way. You should have an interest in Nikon because as competition plays off against each other, you know what happens? We all win. We all win big because it's kind of like the jealous brother routine. Well, he has it. I want it too. You know, so if one camera company does this, the other ones get on the bandwagon to figure out, well, how can we do that also? So the one that's announced right now is the Nikon D850. We thought it was going to be the D820, but Nikon announced that they were developing the D850. So we got the first name. Now, I made a video yesterday saying I was a little bit disappointed in what they did. They had enough time to prepare for their 100th birthday party, and we figured they'd get all dressed up and pull out whatever thing they were going to be displaying and showing. Plus Nikon themselves. Now, this is not something I made up in my mind because I wasn't even thinking of Nikon, you know. So Nikon themselves put it in my head that they're going to put a pro level, high consumer level mirrorless camera in our hands. That's what they're working towards getting. They also put it in our heads that there's going to be a surprise. They also put it in our heads that they filed actually for a dual pixel focus patent on February something 2017. So we know dual pixel focus is something they were thinking about. They filed a patent for it. And besides them, Sony did too. And Sony sells sensors outside of the Sony company to other companies. So Nikon might be developing a sensor that Sony's going to build for them. I don't know. I don't know how that's going to work, but they have figured it out. So what would I like to see in a D850? What would make me interested? Because I'm already in the Nikon pool, but I haven't purchased a Nikon item for a while, even though Nikon was my number one lead camera. And before the Nikon, my number one lead camera, it was the Canon. Now, I still have nice glass in both the Canon line, and I have nice glass, meaning lenses, in the Nikon line. I've thought about selling them, but you know what? I thought if I sell my Nikon lenses, that's when they're going to come out with the camera that I want to buy, right? So it's like stuck between a rock and a hard place. So what type of stuff would I like to see realistically? I'm not talking about a camera made on another planet, all right? I'm talking about realistically. Now, it has 36 megapixels. So what do you think they're gonna do with the 36 megapixels? Are they gonna play with the megapixel race? Because if they are, they're gonna raise it. The more they raise it, a lot of people are gonna be very happy, but there will be a group of people, and I would be in that would not be super happy. I'd rather have something solid, you know, maybe to 42 megapixels. And I pick that out because Sony has a 42 megapixel sensor. Now, if they're developing a new one, I'd like to see them stay at the 36 or something unique, 38, 34, 39, 40 megapixels. But the key here is that the D810 And even my D800E that I've used many years had great dynamic range. I don't want to see them kill the dynamic range. So I'd like to see, even if they stay at 36 megapixels, I'd like to see them keep the dynamic range intact. So, or greater. So it would be dynamic range, which I'm just going to put DR for dynamic range. That's the shortcut. Needs to be greater than what it is now. So in continuing with that, I did see some pictures on Nikon Rumors that showed potential pictures of the camera, leaked images. And what was a little bit disappointing is this is a GH4. I'm shooting on a GH5. With the Olympus Pro 1.2 lens. Now this has an articulating screen, means when I pull it out, it'll go all the way around and I can see from the front, or I can tilt it. I can even face it so I can go up and I can be down here and lower myself down, or I can put it level so I can put it in my lap for unsuspecting people. But the important thing is I can face it forward. So just like what I'm doing now, I can kind of position myself in the screen. Like I could see on my iPhone, well, it's not an iPhone, it's an Android, where I'm positioned in the frame. But I did see in this picture from Nikon Rumors that there was buttons up and down here. So how could they put a hinge here if there's buttons over here? So they'd have to move at least two buttons in order for the hinge to be able to grab. They would have to be kind of like that hinge would be, you know. So I don't know if they're willing to do that. I'm not a big fan of just the tilt only, because I think an articulating screen fully able to swing all the way out is necessary in today's day and age, because there's all kinds of uses for it. So I'd like to see that happen. If not, have full capable Wi-Fi ability. You know, here's the Olympus EM1. Now the Olympus EM1 does not swing, it just tilts. So I could pull it out, it'll go, so I can look straight down if the camera was like this. It'll tilt this way, so I can put the camera higher. And I am short, so it's an advantage to me. You know, so it allows all the tiltability in this direction. So what I would like preferably is for it to come out here. If I can bend my hand that much. Hello, I like to keep that hand. That is my writing hand, you know. So that's the difference between a tilting screen and an articulating screen. So I would prefer the articulating screen. But just as important, if they don't do anything and they keep it flat, they need to do like Canon and Panasonic, and they make it so I can see on my smartphone. I can actually stop it and start it. I can do the focusing. I can change the ISO. I can stop and start the video recording also, and I can take pictures right from the smartphone. So that would kind of be a way around not having an articulating screen, is to make sure that the Wi-Fi is fully functional. So I would like that to be included. Now, they said they were going to come out with a mirrorless camera, meaning there's no mirror in the camera. When you take the lens off of this camera, there's no mirror. You see directly into the sensor. So when you can actually see into the sensor, they call that mirrorless because there's no mirror. Now, as soon as you put a mirror in there, it becomes a reflex camera. It would be called a DSLR, digital single lens reflex camera. There's a twin lens reflex cameras. That's one of the Minolta twin lens reflex cameras that I used to use. Reflex means there's a reflection. It doesn't mean that it's a mirror that goes up and down, because a twin lens reflex camera has a mirror in it, but it has two lenses, one on top of each other. So it's a twin lens reflex, but the mirror doesn't go up and down. So the twin lens the SDLR stands for a reflection. So anyway, I'd like to have it so that in the new D850 that you can actually put the mirror up and shoot but it would be completely silent. High-end Nikons, and it's not on the high-end Canons. Nikon needs to bring it in to the 850. So we need an electronic shutter. That's the short version. I want an electronic shutter when the mirror is up. Obviously, you cannot have electronic shutter if the camera does have a mirror, because with the mirror, it uses a completely different focus system. And that brings me to the next item on my wish list for the D850. I know they have a patent because they filed it already for dual pixel focus. Let's put it into the D850. Do I think it's going to happen? No. I really don't, but I'm making a wish list, all right? So let's put dual pixel focus. And of course, along with that, like I just said, the electronic shutter, because that makes the camera completely silent. There's just something about being able to take pictures without the shutter sound alerting people. How many times when I raise the camera up to take a picture, especially when I do weddings and the preparations, then the bride gets a whiff of it, they turn around and it's like, what is that? You know, I don't want that. If I wanted posed pictures, I'd pose you. You know, now I can't be rude and say something like that. You got to stay nice, you know. So if it's silent, like the GH4 will shoot silently, the Olympus EM1 will shoot silently, the new GH5 that I'm shooting on right now, filming right now, will shoot silently. The Sonys will shoot silently. I like Nikon since they have the opportunity to shoot silently. Now you realize this wish list is not going to come true because it's already in motion. They are planning the 860, okay? So what's in the 850, the outskirts, the outline is already made. But hey, I wanted to make a video and share what I wanted on there. And if they can't do dual pixel focus, then do something better than contrast detection, because the contrast detection on all of the Nikons, thumbs down, it sucks. What other words can I use? Do something that's a little bit solid. Sony is able to do it, and they don't have dual pixel focus. So, you know, that brings us to the movie area, you know. I would like 4K, and I'm pretty sure we're going to get 4K. What I would like is a few different flavors of 4K, and if I can possibly stretch the envelope, and this is going to be 2-in-1. I'd like them to have the ability to get rid of the CF cards, the ones with the pins. The pins are out. All cards with pins, go bye-bye. No more pins that can bend and your camera is down for the rest of the event. You know, now it's pretty good. It doesn't bend any pins that often, but when you do, your camera broke. It is broke, you know, and I just ain't got no time for that. I need the camera to be working. And I need it to be working well through the whole event. So the new SD cards that are the V90, where they can sustained 90 megabytes per second. Don't just look at the advertisements. Oh, this card goes to 230, and that's not the sustained speed. We need a sustained speed so it can record 4K in 30p or even possibly 60p. So moving into the video side of it, at least the SD cards, the new ones, or what is that XQD that they've been using? That, further develop that. Even though Lexar is abandoning it, other companies will probably pick up the slack on that. Sony makes them. So having that card and maybe the V90 slot, the SD, in there, so there'll be two card slots. And that brings us to 4K capabilities. Now, with 4K capabilities, you've got different flavors of 4K, okay? You have, different flavors of quality. You've got 1080, all right? And we call that 1080p. And you've got 4K. Now, you can do great 4K and really lousy 1080, and that's Sony. They actually oversample and from a larger than 4K and downsample it down to 4K, meaning you're getting advantage of higher quality running in the camera all the time. The Canon video cinema line C100 actually shoots in 4K, but they don't allow you to record that. They downsample it down to 1080, so you get the benefits of shooting 4K and having the resolution at 1080 rather than just a straight 1080 resolution. So I'd like Nikon to be able to take the 1080 and give a thumbs up. How do we do a thumbs up? Okay, quality of 1080, because that brings us to the 4K capabilities. Most people that are doing some kind of work or even high-level enthusiasts know that if you have a 30p timeline in your computer or a 24p timeline in your computer, you shoot at 60p or higher and you drop it on that 30p or 24p and you get real beautiful slow motion. But if your 1080 is crappy, you're going to have not very good looking slow motion. You're going to have poor quality slow motion. So I'd like them to concentrate on their 1080 quality. This is one of the areas where Canon has fallen down. Not the only one, but they don't, you know, like on the 5D Mark IV, it'll shoot 4K, but you're forced to shoot their flavor, which is an MJPEG format. So if you go to the 1080 because you want to go around about that, the 1080 should be top of the line quality. I mean, we're paying $3,500 and up for these cameras, guys, you know. So it is my money and it's your money. You work hard for it. You finally pick out which camera you want to buy, and there it goes. The money's out the window. So you want something in your hands that you can be really proud of, you know, and something that works together with you. So basically, you need 30p and you need 60p. Now, if they can do that in 4K, which I really don't think is likely, okay, not at the price range of a D850, it'd be a nice surprise, okay, but I don't think it's likely. Then they need to do that in 1080 with a high quality and give us 30p, 60p, and even 120p, and not in 720 or some ridiculously crop size, and not at a lower quality level. So they need to give us good 1080. Now, this is doable. This is not pie in the sky. Oh, I'm just pulling out whatever I want and stick it in my custom camera. No, this is really doable. 1080 high quality is something that every camera company should be able to do. Now, what they choose to do with 4K, I don't know. Chances of them going to MJPEG like Canon did, which was a poor thing and a great thing at the same time, I don't think is likely. So what's the codec going to be? I hope that there's enough megabytes per second, so it gives a good quality 4K. Now, if they wanted to push the envelope and not have to redesign their camera, they can add at least maybe two flavors of ProRes, because if once you experience ProRes, you know, you ain't going to want to go back. You know, once you try ProRes, you don't go back. It stays. That's what you want. As a matter of fact, the recorders that you buy that are separate that go into the HDMI plugs, those recorders record in ProRes. It's a very high quality. It's not quite as good as RAW, but mighty close. And that's saying a pretty big mouthful for something that's compressed and manipulated and chopped up and all that kind of stuff. So if they were able to add 4K ProRes as a choice, even if it's an additional price, you know how they add a firmware? Well, if you want the firmware that allow you to record in ProRes, it's another $200. You know, I'd buy that in a heartbeat, because I recognize the quality of ProRes and I've recognized the workflow of ProRes. So if they give the ability for ProRes in some fashion, that would be awesome, okay? That is not pie in the sky. It's something that's in the Atomos recorders. So, you know, and I'm talking about a $300 recorder that I have that is only 1080, but when I shoot it, I shoot ProRes, you know, because it's, you know, that high of a quality. So I got the dual pixel focus. Let's run this down for the video. Dual pixel focus. I'd like some of the just basic focus peaking, maybe zebras, just a few little helpful things in the video department. So we have addressed the stills and the video. Now, what are they likely to do? Okay, they are likely to take the D810 and just step it up a notch. They're going to put some kind of a 4K in there. If they choose to put a clean HDMI output for 4K, that would be absolutely awesome, because then I could take that camera and I could record it any way I want by buying my own recorder, one of the Atomos recorders or the Blackmagic recorder. They can do it in camera. So they'll have some type of 4K. Let's just hope that it's good enough and that they also address the focus system so that it's not just about the worst out there, you know. It can't keep lock on anything. It's not good. So if they can address that, that's probably what they'll do. And then they'll call it an 850 and call it a day. So they'll bump up a few things here and bump up a few things there. But that is my wish list. And that's what I'm hoping for in the D850. All right, guys. You know, if there's something that you'd like to see that's reasonable, okay, these guys actually have to produce the camera. It's not like Bewitched where somebody twitches their nose and boom, here's the new 850. It slices, it dices, it makes pizza for you. It's a toaster oven. It's a dishwasher. It's a Vitamix all rolled up into one. So you can make breakfast, lunch, and dinner with the D850. And in your spare time, you can go out and shoot a wedding. So that's not what I'm talking about. All right. So what kind of a feature would you like to see on there that they can actually do and still remain profitable? Because that's the name of the game. That's why they make the cameras. They have to be profitable. So that brings us to the last thing. You thought I was going to end it, right? The price. Now, there's a large army marching out there that always wants the $3,500 camera, okay? And they want it for $1,500, okay? Lower the price, lower the price. Give us everything and lower that price. Door number one, door number two, or door number three. I don't want no doors. I want a lower price. That's not realistic. They're there to make money. So what do you think the price is going to be? I think they're going to keep it in line with Canon's 5D Mark IV, which is $3,500. Now they raised it by $100 by adding S-Log to it. They lowered it from $34.99 for the 5D Mark IV. Came out at $34.99. You want one? Here, give us $3,499. $3,500? No, we just want $34.99. You could keep your extra dollar. Okay. Then they came out with S-Log, but decided it's going to cost more. So what they did is they lowered the $34.99 to $32.99. So if you go to B&H Photo, you will see that the 5D Mark IV is now $32.99, $3,299. However, if you want the new S-Log, they took the $34.99 and raised it to $35.99. So they figured out how to charge $100 extra, but we still get the possible bargain of $32.99. So we've already had our first price cut on the 5D Mark IV. So things are looking good. I just want to see Nikon get into the game, okay? Most of the things that I mentioned are very doable. Some of them are not likely. They would be big surprises. But some of them is something that would really bring it into the advanced stages of where we're in with other cameras now, like a complete silent electronic shutter, so that when the mirror is up, you could take a picture, tap on the screen. Oh, I would like a nice tap screen. Did I mention that? How could I have missed that? I want a nice tap screen. You know who makes a really good tap screen? Canon. And you know who else makes a great tap screen? Is the GH5 from Panasonic. Wonderful tap screens. So I'd like a tap LCD on the back of the camera so that I could tap, focus, and fire. Or tap, and that's where it's going to focus and follow focus on. So I would like that. So those couple of items are very doable. Staying within the 36 megapixel and not going to some crazy 55 megapixel, you know, and the quality goes to down the toilet, I'd like them to do that too. So thanks for staying with me on my wish list. So how do we separate reality from fiction? You'll have to listen to what I said and kind of figure out which parts is a very doable part and which parts are not doable parts. So that's what we've got. That's my wish list. And now I need to ask somebody very important what they think about this whole thing. And you know who that is, right? All right, come here. Okay. Let's say hello. All right, listen. Come here, listen. I just made a wish list, okay, for the new D850. See it right here? Right here. I made a wish list for the new D850. And I want to know what you think. Tell me what you think, Jingles. He likes my whole wish list. Yeah, he does. This is a family show, so we bring in our guard attack dog. So this is our guard attack dog. So anybody that wants to rob the house, they have to make it past him. And he's ferocious, right, Jingles? He's eyeing something in there right now. And, you know, I wind up having to protect him more than him protecting me. Although he is great, if somebody comes to the door, I know it before anybody else because he's going crazy. Just when a car goes into the driveway, I don't know, does he got supersonic hearing? So anyway, we've moved Jingle Bells time just for a few videos up into the video rather than after the video. So I appreciate that. And we'll put him on the couch over here. And we've reached the end of the roll. Thank you guys for staying with me. That's our D850 wish list. I will catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching. Thanks for staying with me. Thanks for being a subscriber. If you haven't subscribed, I would like to ask you to subscribe, please. That lets you know when I make new videos. So if you can do that and give it a like, that would be very nice. Thanks. Peter, live from the Christmas room. Catch you later. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.